Annette Alfred is considered the grand dame of culture in Tobago. Her initiation into the world of performing arts started at the tender age of 4. Annette, or Nettie, as she's fondly called, pursued academic studies in drama and theater arts. She worked extensively in the field of culture, with accomplishments ranging from Tobago Academy of the Performing Arts to receiving the Public Servant Medal of Merit Gold. The former Cultural Officer 3 is credited for the resurgence of maypole dancing in Tobago. Here she is with a brief history of maypole dancing.
My understanding is started in the 15th century in Western Europe, places like Germany, Sweden, Portugal, England. There is when the maypole started. It was in May, because May is when the spring starts. As a child, I knew the maypole very well. I came into Scarborough to go to school, and I used to, well, I saw it in my home village. Then when I came to Scarborough, I used to see people dancing it and stuff like that. I remember reading somewhere in England, they used to dress up like royalty to go and do the maypole. In my time, or in our time, you'd use our little flare skirts with your knickers, of course, and your night peasant blouse, something kind of shaped like this, your peasant blouse. And these, well, I've seen all sorts of fancy clothes, sometimes some of them very crazy and unsuitable, but I've seen all types of clothes. I believe it comes with the time. In the 80s and the 90s, there was hardly any maypole around us. But on the advent of the Tobago Heritage Festival, people like me were in the forefront, where we went to research what we had, what used to be here. We did our research. Out of the blue came the maypole. I said, oh wait, you know, we used to have the maypole, and it's so nice, it's so pretty. I was in charge of the culture department. It's around 1999. I said, this is something I must bring back to our children. You see, and it enables so many people to learn it, because I mean, you could use 10, 12 people. So then you have a chance for other children to learn and stuff like that. And I decided, I said, I'm going to reintroduce this thing. I put it as a part of my plan, and my, well, you want to call it my bosses or whoever was in charge, thought it was a bright idea. I did a lot of homework. We went to the schools, we also visited groups, youth groups, village groups, and so on. And on the first occasion, I call it the reintroduction day, we had about 28 primary schools. 28 schools, I shouldn't say primary, because we had one or two secondary schools. And about six village groups, they came out to dance in maypole. And just went on, and every year we had the maypole, Once we were giving prizes after time, we were just doing it as more of a festival rather than a competition, and because then you get more people wanting to take part if it's a festival. Apart from dancing myself, which I loved, you notice the EDA, which I loved to do, what made me very, very happy once was the very first time we had the reintroduction of the maypole. It was really, 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 really nice to know that people responded so well to it and enjoyed what it was. And for me, it meant something to me. You know, you got to realize that, but this was sleeping all the time, and look how people are enjoying it.
Now that you have been briefed on maypole dancing in Tobago, click on the YouTube link below to learn how.